Yes, hello. So, I'm not any kind of YouTuber, so this is my first kind of video that I ever did up for YouTube. And I do it especially for Johannes, who just bought some new 701 Husqvarna. And I would like to present some mods that I did to my bike, and maybe it's some kind like, to give you some ideas what you can do with this bike and what I built this bike for. So, I guess we just start from the back side. So what you can see here is I didn't change the fender in any way. So I thought about to change this fender to some real short one, but I had the experience with some colleagues of mine that all of the dirt and all of the mud that comes from your back tire will land directly on your seat and on your backside. Camera is still on, yes. And so I didn't change it in any way because it's just useless for me in my way of riding. So if you're really going for dirt riding only and not like traveling like I do, then you can change it because you will clean your bike every time. But if you're going for long adventure rides, like for a few weeks, then you don't need to change it, or I would not like to change it because it just makes you dirty and and it's not necessary. So down here, I changed the tire to the Pirelli MT21. You can see it just here, and Pirelli MT21 Rally Cross version. And I have to say, this is some amazing tire. So before I had the TKC 80, and it's some good kind of tire if you go for of course on the street and as well as some gravel roads, for example. But if you are really heading like for dirt, mud, sand and stuff like that, then it would definitely become a better idea to change the tire immediately to some knobby. More knobby one, because the sand and mud will just fly away because of this negative profile here, and it's much easier to ride with this one. I also had the experience on some events that I could ride some trails and some sections that some colleagues of mine with the same bike were not able to do because of the tire. They had some, I guess, Heidenau and also Karoo 3 and stuff like that, and they came not up the hill, so it's a good idea to change the tire. I also changed the inner tubes to the 4 mm ones from Michelin, to the ultra heavy duty ones, and I was thinking that I could experience some kind of worse handling in the end because of the heavier inner tube, but I didn't recognize any change of the handling up to now. So for me, it's a good idea to change directly to the 4 mm inner tubes, and you won't feel any difference. So from the tires directly up to the backside of the motorbike. So you can see right now here exactly that I changed or that I installed the Perun Moto rack system. So it's like mounted on 4 points in the backside. So there are some inner threads on the tank, of course, but you have to drill the holes here into the plastics by yourself. But if you remove the plastics, you will find some indication points where to set the drill. So it's quite easy to install this kind of plate. It has some good advantage because you can, of course, fit some lugs here. So I have two because this one was on the front side before, but I don't have any space on the front side anymore, so I put it just on the back side. But if you want to roll your bike out of the dirt into the garage or somewhere else, these points become really like very helpful. One more interesting fact. Oh, this one is my small toddler. is that you can just put an add-on here, and this one is quite amazing because it's from this kayaking or canoe sports, and you can order it in different sizes, and so you got some strap around here, and you just put it beneath the rack, and you fix it with some kind of like wire straps or cable ties, and you have some perfect place to fit some small items on the bike, like your gloves or some stuff you just bought or yeah, anything that you need space for. So I really love this rack, and I just recommend to put some kind of like net on top of it, and it holds a lot of things. Yeah, just to go on the back side is I changed the fuel cap to the Vanage one. So I did it because of the optics, also because of the point that if you use the original one and you put your key inside, I just heard about and recognized that it was very, very hard to turn the key. So I was frightened really, like if it will come mud and dirt inside, that it will be much more hard or harder to move the key, and that you will just break it. I read it inside some foreign forum that it happened often to some people, so I just changed it immediately. And this part is really quite sealed, so I just fell over a lot of times, and I never had any drop of gas coming out of this tank. So I also put this I don't know what it's called here from Krieger, this loops for the OS system, OS 6 combo. So you just put the hooks through here, and the other side of the base rack of this OS combo system just through here and inside the loop again, and then this complete system is fixed. So you can put it here, or you can mount it within 1 minute and release it in 1 minute. It's quite easy. So this holes were already inside, and this lugs, they came with the OS rack, and it's just like a bottom plate here. You put it through, just tied it down here, and this is fixed. So I will show the system later on in this video when I have put it on. So next up down here, I put some heel cap, I think it's called, to mount the Krieger base system or the Moscow Motor one. So you can choose which one you want to have here. You have three kind of loops that you can use. I like this very much. I think it's also from Perun. I don't know exactly which brand it was of, but it was around 50 bucks or anything, so not that expensive. So you can use another one, of course, like the plastic ones from made of HDPE, high dense polyethylene, or you go with a aluminium one. I choose this one. I like it. I can recommend it. And you can as well put some lug as here from Krieger directly through. So yeah, it's quite helpful. So what I did down here is I bought some FE frame or swing arm protection, it didn't fit, of course, because it's a little bit different, but with some Dremel you can just cut around some edges here and as well down here, and you can make it fit. In the end, it's not like necessary to have this part. I just did it for the optics. I don't know if I like it yet or not. I just have it since a few weeks. I don't think that it really will protect anything. Instead, it's getting like dirt here inside and behind this plastic cover. So I even think I would damage it more instead of protecting it. But I guess I will see in the future when I remove it, and up to now I will leave it on for the next few weeks, and then I will make a decision if I will use it or not. So next up, here are the my food bags. So before I had also the one from Rada Garage. I liked them, I enjoyed them, and they were, I think, 1 centimeter more below. So it was better for my knees to use this one. These are as well a little bit lower. But my issue was that these inner screws of the Rada Garage foot pegs were loosening due to the vibration of the motor and the frame. I also used, of course, Loctite, but I keep losing some pins every time. So someday I said, okay, fuck it, let's move on to another foot peg, and I choose the Bosley one. And yeah, this one is of course handmade and welded, and it's quite a big one, and I have a perfect stand on it, and yeah, I could not say anything bad up to now for of these pegs or about these pegs. They are quite large, they are even larger than the Rada Garage one, so I yeah enjoy them pretty much. So next up, I also put some protection, some plastic cover on the coupling. So it's quite a big protection, and it's mounted on 1, 2, and I guess there was another point which it was mounted on, but I can't find it right now. So yeah, if I fell over or fall over and there were some kind of like pointy rocks or stuff like that, it's not that dangerous to get directly through this cast iron or cast material and to break it. So I like it very much. So you see it also has some small scratches here and some impact points, and yeah, it is protecting very well the motorbike. But on the opposite hand, so this, I guess, so it's just my feeling, I guess that it makes, or it keeps the motor in some hotter condition. So I guess when you remove this one, you have some better, of course, airflow here. You can remove some heat. So I think you will drive on a little bit higher temperature, oil temperature and stuff like that. I recognize it because also in cold weather conditions, my air fan from the radiator is like turning on, and yeah, I don't know why it turns on, because it's like 10 degrees or 5 degrees, and you're going off-roading. Okay, you drive very slow and not that fast, but I would not have thought that this fan will turn on in this condition. So I will put it on, yeah, maybe this cover, and of course on the other side, on the opposite side, you also have the same cover to protect the motor or the engine from the other side as well. Next up, we have the famous AXP bash plate. So I'm very, very happy with this bash plate. So you have some, yeah, maintenance holes here to remove the screws here to release the oil. You also have some opening here as well to do some maintenance. I can see it right now from this side. This one is very, very sturdy. It keeps a lot of rocks and yeah, mud and dirt away. So it's quite wide, I would say. I was also a little bit worried that if I will fall over, that this kind like of welding here, this plastic welding, will break. But I fell over a lot of times, and up to now, nothing broke. So it's protecting, of course, the brake cylinder here, as well as the shock linkage down here. So you can slide just above obstacles without getting stuck here on this linkage. One big downside that I have with this AXP, maybe it was my fault, I don't know exactly, is that I lost my first one in Belgium. So I was on the Trans-Euro Trail in Belgium, and I was riding like not paved roads, like gravel roads and loose roads, and it was a little bit bumpy, and I lost it. So I just came to the campsite in the evening, and I was thinking, okay, my bike looks a little bit different, so what changed? And I just came to the Yeah, well, I just found out that this one was gone, and yeah, it was because of the vibration, I guess, of the frame and the points here. So I also used Loctite, of course, on the first one, on these mounting points, and I was still losing it. So I found it very dangerous in this situation in cornering. Just imagine you will lose your bash plate. It comes beneath your rear wheel, and you're just cornering, and yeah, of course you just slip away, and you will have some major crash, maybe. So what I did, and what I can recommend, is to put some, yeah, kind like strap here or on any place, just to fix it. If it comes loose and will fall off, then it will just light on the ground. You will hear it, and it will not get beneath your rear wheel. So this I would really like, yeah, I would really recommend. So next up, on the front side, on the fork, I'm using the Acerbis sleeve or protection cover or whatever it's called. So you will get it in different versions. You will get it as a closed one, but then you have to remove everything just to install it and to remove it. So I was going for the Acerbis one with a zip here. You can see it. You have some sleeve around here to fix this slip to the zip. And if you want to remove it, you just, yeah, of course, pull down the strip, cut the wire strap down here, and you can remove it and just check your front fork. And I would really, really recommend it. Also, Linton Poskitt is using neoprene ones, but in the end, it's he's using ones, and I would really like recommend it, because I was on an event with my old bike, with my Honda Africa Twin Adventure Sports, which I sold because I got this beauty, and it was like a 2 days event. And yeah, we were riding the first day through mud and stuff like that. So overnight we get to the tent, we go to sleep. In the morning we woke up, and I didn't think of cleaning anything down here. And I didn't have these covers, of course. And so we just started the bikes and go for the next trip and so on. And in the evening, so both of the seals, of the fork seals, were damaged on my bike, because all of this mud which was stuck here were pushing in my seal and were immediately destroying them. So whether you think about to clean your fork every day from this stuck and aggressive mud, or you will use some sleeves like that, and yeah, I guess it won't happen. So for me, it's okay. I didn't have any fork damage up to now, and yeah, I'm quite fine with it. So the next small item, but which I'm very proud of, is this one. And I just got recommended this from by a colleague, which I got to know on some enduro events in Germany. So he had the same one on his front fork, and I was asking, okay, what is this kind of piece? And yeah, it's a shovel. It's a very lightweight aluminium shovel with some straps here that are mounted on the front fork with some rubber, so that the metal is not touching the other metal, and do some scratch it and stuff like that. So you can do as you want, but in the end, it's quite nice to have this one, so you not have to use your hand. In any case, you will get stuck in the mud. Instead, you just use this small shovel, and you don't waste your hands or destroy your hands, or you don't destroy your gloves, your good new ones, or your leather gloves. And instead, you use this shovel. Shovel your bike free, and use the lugs that I just showed on the backside to, yeah, remove it. So I can just recommend it. It's called the Deuce, and it's made in Colorado by blah 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 Tent Lab, whatever. So I guess if you Google the Deuce, you will find the right item. Also, some small feature that I did is I just put some neon tape here where the valve is. So I like the optic. I also did it on the backside, so I just stole it from the Norden. I saw the pictures back then from the Norden 901, and I immediately liked this design, and it's quite helpful if you're on the gas station or you want to release tire pressure or you want to put some tire pressure on, to find immediately your valve. And I guess you can choose its size and just put it around the rim a little bit here, you just put it inside. So it looks good, and it helps a little bit, so I can also recommend that. So coming to the other side, as you can see here, I use a Leo Venture Nero Euro 5 version, of course with cut. You can maybe see it here right now. I changed it because the old one was getting very, very hot in the end. So I changed it because I use a Moscomoto Reckless 80, and it was like burning, and I tried to put some heat tape around. I tried to put some distance pieces on the original exhaust, and nothing quite worked quite well. So I had to use the money, or had to spend the money to get some other exhaust, and I chose this one because I saw it on it's a German YouTuber. He's called The Pirate in English. In Deutsch it's Der Pirat, and he has a test bench, and he tested all these exhaust systems and stuff like that. And this was the exhaust with the most power output or upgrade, and you can check his videos out. Maybe I will put the link down below. And of course it's not getting as hot as the original one. So the original one was getting so hot. So you just drove like 20 kilometers, you stopped your bike, you put your hand on the exhaust by accident, and you just immediately burned your hand. So I changed it. I'm happy right now, but I also have to mention that it burns the plastics anyway. So if you put some weight on here with your Reckless system, Moscomoto, or with your Krieger OS system, it will push directly on the exhaust. Maybe I will install some distance piece here, and to remove it a little bit. But anyway, this is some plastic which you can change for a few bucks. But down here, of course, in this direction here, or in this area, so you have the cut, and this one is the hot part of the exhaust system. So yeah, even if you change it, you maybe destroy a little bit of your plastics, but anyway you have more torque, more power, and a really nice sound. So the sound is not like very aggressive like the short ones you get from Leo Winch, is a short system, but it was kind of like embarrassing to ride with a short one because it was so damn loud, and I didn't enjoy it in any way because like I said, it was embarrassing, and I'm not the guy who wants to have the loudest motorbike in any way. So yeah, I choose this one, and I can also recommend this. So down here you can also see that I have this this cover or this protection, as on the other side I just showed before. Of course also this heel protection, and I use this Constance bike lifter, and I have to say I'm really happy with this part. I already used it before for my Africa Twin, and you just buy this one, you can exchange this piece here depending on which bike you have, and on the Husqvarna 701 it just goes here inside this hole which is already on the motorbike, and you will just have to put some cap here to get the pin inside from the button lift arm, so that the motorbike will not tip over in any direction. Of course you need 2 points, but it's not very hard to install, and I just can like maybe lift it right now. Oh no, here's secure, so I have to normally put it down, remove the security pin here, and then I can lift it up and down. And yeah, for maintenance work, for me, it is quite nice. So I can change the wheels on the front, on the back, without any problems. I can loop my chain, I can do some small service. Yeah, so I can recommend this, as all the items I have recommended before as well. Yeah, here you see the cover of the generator. I guess it's a generator, so please excuse me if I'm wrong here. It's the same brand as on the other side, but yeah, there are a lot of brands, so I guess you can choose any, and you will get some better protection in the end. So yeah, quite nice. So getting to the front side of the machine, as a tank bag. So I have on the back side, I have of course this net for some small items like, yeah, if you buy milk or whatever, you can put it here. And yeah, for my maybe camera equipment or stuff like that, I just bought the smallest tank bag that I could find. So I enjoy this one pretty much because, yeah, as I just thought, it's very small. Its capacities, I guess, was it 1 liter? I guess it was 1 liter. So you can put some stuff up here. So here I have some just small knife, and inside here some equipment and cables and whatever you want to put inside here. So this one is complete waterproof. You can also dismount it very, very fast, so by just releasing these buckles here and these buckles down here on both sides. You can see it. So, and there you go. So it's gone. You can remove it as fast as I just showed here. Yeah, I also enjoy this one pretty much. So coming to the controls and fairing and rally tower and yeah. So let's just start here on this one. This one I have like 1 or 2 weeks. So yeah, it's quite expensive in the end, so yeah, you have to think about if you want to use it or not. So it's of course a steering damper from Scotts, as you can see here. I have the Rade Garage F5 kit, so, and the F5 kit is already coming with this holder for the pin and the pin itself. And if you order this one, you can already install it, because also this lifting or this distance piece for the handlebar is also coming with it. So everything is fitted for the installation of the Scotts, and it's, yeah, like a 5 minute installation to put it on and to bolt these two screws over here. And the big benefit that I just recognized is on some muddy ways, muddy high speed ways, or on sand, it's becoming really, really, really helpful. So if you're going a little bit faster on mud roads, on stuff like that, or sand, as I just said, you know, you have the trails that some bikes put before you on the ground, and often your front tire will just follow this kind of trails. With this one, you can, yeah, control the damping here, the low speed damping and the high speed damping here, and you just feel it that you won't follow this lines anymore. So you just go to this direction where your front wheel is pointing to, and it's not like shaking all the time and bringing you into some dangerous situations. Instead, it's really helpful, and I drive a lot safer in the end with this piece. I would not have thought that this made some serious impact like that. But yes, I enjoy it. So you can also, yeah, just to come to the functions, you can also turn the screw here and on the other side. So this is a sweep, so it will give you the degrees from when the handlebar is turning free. So you only have like a triangle, like this and this, depending on the screws that you set up left and right. And Yeah, this one will only damp within this triangle. So if you get out of this triangle, it will release and will become much easier. Especially this is used for cornering, single trail riding, for example. If you have some very small corners and you're working really on the end of the handlebar, you want to have some kind like resistance in this area. Instead, it's released then. So, but you can easily set it up here with these clicks and do it more, or set it up more hard, or even softer. Yes, you have to find your own setting. And I just found out that I really change it a lot. Depending on the ground. So if I ride on the highway, I just use like 8 clicks from the full close position. If I ride on the mud, I will put 8 more to the hard side, and on sand even harder, depending on the speed. So as expensive as this item is, it helps a lot, and keeps you even more safe. So, next up on my handlebar, the controls. I use the Carpeita Terrain Command 2. So, the Carpeita system is some Bluetooth controller for your mobile device. So, if you use Android, or you have to use Android, otherwise it won't work. So, it does not match with iOS systems. You have 8 buttons. And you have some Bluetooth connector, which is connected to the battery, of course. This one I put behind this cover here. You have this, toolbox. And this toolbox I just emptied out. I don't need this single tools, whatever is inside. And I put this small this Bluetooth controller inside and connected it to the battery and connected it to the bottom button down here. So if I turn this one on, it will turn on the Bluetooth device on this side, and this one is activated and will directly connect to my mobile, which is normally mounted here. So the great advantage is that when you're riding, you and you have a map open like Google Maps or whatever, so you can zoom in, zoom out. You can move the map up and down. You can move the map and left and right. You can centralize your position and stuff like that. So it's quite amazing not to remove your hand to reach here and to scroll with your fingers down, up, or to zoom in and zoom out. Instead, you do all those controls from the handlebar right here. And even for upcoming rallies, hopefully I will attend to some. This one is quite helpful because you have your digital roadbook here. So your digital roadbook is nothing else as a Android device. And you have a PDF inside, and the trip meter, and some here. This direction with degrees and stuff. I don't know the English word right now. And you can scroll the roadbook, of course, up and down, and reset the trip master or correct it with these buttons. And you don't have to stop and put it manually in. So this is quite nice. So I would like to attend some rallies in the future. I also have some second GPS bar. So the second GPS bar, I have some paper roadbook on, but I don't have any more space here to put any more buttons. So I'm not quite sure right now how I do it, because I would like to run 2 setups, one digital one, one paper roadbook. Yeah, but let's see how this will figure out in the future. But up to now, I'm quite happy to have this one for daily trips, TT riding, GPX riding, track riding and stuff. Because you can keep your hand on the handlebar, and you can keep riding pretty safe. So of course I also changed the mirrors here. So these are some foldable ones, but really I I used some cheap ones from Amazon. They were like 15 bucks or anything. So, but I have them since I have this bike, so nothing bad about this to say. So, you can just put it here so it will lock and not move. And the same, of course, on this side. For the street, it's quite perfect, so you can see everything. It's not vibrating too that much. And on the trails, you just put them in the middle, so you not get stuck within some tree or some loose green stuff wherever you ride through. The last major part that I changed on my motorbike is I put the Radegarage F5 fairing in the front of it. It's also quite new. I have it since a few months, 2 months or I guess. But I have to say it's like really, really amazing. So the weather and wind protection is much, much better as anything I put on before. So of course I also had this original lamp here, and I used to install some brackets here and some windshield from MRR approximately here, and it was also giving some better wind protection. But in the end you keep on hitting this windscreen directly into your face every time you go up like steep hills. You would have this windscreen directly in your helmet, and that sucked a lot. I choose this one because of course I like this. I like the carbon optic, or not optic, the carbon tower, so it's like real carbon. You can check it out on their homepage. The looks itself, of course, I like this very much. I like this rally optic. I like this carved windscreen. I like that I can replace this part of the screen in front. Just imagine you get hit by some stones from your buddy who's driving in front, so this one will damage and scratch, and so you can order this as a spare part. You remove it, put a new one in. This is quite nice. The only thing that I have with this fairing is that it's not easy to get it road legal, at least in Germany. So I really have to find some TÜV who is gonna make it road legal for me. So I got to know somebody who knows somebody who knows somebody and who will, legalize this one. So I guess within the next months, I will also have this one like road legal. But in the end, I can like really recommend it because you have the low beam and the high beam. It's much brighter. At the old halogen H4 lamp, I guess it was. And it's awesome. It's also awesome that the windscreen is wider in the front, so it's not like here, it's more like here. And if you're riding, like I just told you, steep hills and you go up there, you're not punching this edge of the windscreen directly to your face. Instead you won't feel it. It puts some more weight on your bike. Yes, that's true. So I guess it's like the overall system with the plastic, the windscreen, LED light, radio tower, GPS bar, and stuff like that. It's and also the clamps, of course, which are down on this side here and below there, but you can see it right now. It will approximately put on, I guess it was like 4.5 kilos or something like that. But in the end, you will still have some very light bike. And it depends on the way you ride this bike. So you can still hit single trails, no problem. But the really difficult sections, it's a little bit more. You have to get into it. So it feels a little bit different. It makes the bike. You think that the bike is a little bit bigger, and it's becoming more like a not road bike, but it's hard to explain. You have to ride it by yourself. But in the end, you will recognize the 4.5 kilos, and you will feel that your bike became a little bit larger. And for some people, it's maybe, let's say, hard to get used to it. But I did, and I can really recommend it, and I enjoyed it so much to have a big space here, because also alone this GPS bar is worth it. So you don't have your GPS down here or with some big arm here and then here in this direction, whatever. No, you have it just right in front of your field of view, and you don't have to look down every time, get neck pain. You don't have to remove your eyes from the road or from the track. Instead, you just keep looking forward and use it directly here. So you can mount everything. So you can mount like ram mounts, clamps, and road books and stuff like that. Some changes which that I did to this fairing are that I changed the screws over here. So I made it like so that you can use it by hand. For example, so you have 1, 2, 3, and 4 of this fixing points for the screws. You can easily remove them by hand right now. Then you have, of course, this holding point behind your seat. So you just put the nose of your seat inside here, and as you can see, so it's really like very, very sturdy, huh? So it's also like damped here with a rubber bracket distance pieces, and so that you not get so much vibration to the GPS bar. And really, I'm quite amazed by the quality. And they had some nice sale, so they had 20% off when I bought this one. So instead of 1,300, I paid, I guess, 1,060. For this complete setup. So it's much cheaper as comparable ones from Nomad, ADV, or Aurora, and some some other brands. So this one is by far the cheapest one that I can find, and by far the one with the best price quality relation. So yeah, what I did here is I also put some fuse box here, so you can drill some holes inside the carbon, of course. And I put some main power line from the battery here to the fuse box. So these four pins are the fuse outlets, or the outlets with the different fuses. So if you put any gear on your front side, on your fairing, you can easily connect it here. With the plus, and the minus is, of course, inside the tower. So I also have some kind like terminal with four clamps, and I change also the screws here, so you can remove the screws by hand. You can open up the tower easily, connect the minus of the depending device that you want to use, and it's perfect. So you have the ABS button here to turn it off. You have the traction control still here. You have the three normal units and your dashboard. So really, it's nice. It's helpful, and for my kind of riding, it's perfect, because I also go for some trips for a few weeks, and I want to have this wind protection, weather protection. I want to have the better GPS bar. I want to have all these advantages that this tower brings. Also the better light. So it's really perfect, and you can still drive single trails. Your bike is still capable of a lot of things that other heavier adventure bikes are not capable of. And so you should check it out, and maybe write Richard from Rade Garage a mail and ask him for some discount, because what I did is I did exactly the same. So I asked him, because unfortunately, because of Corona, there are no fairs in any way, and normally you go to some motorcycle fair and you get to know the suppliers or this brands. You talk to the guys, and they will give you some discount code. And because of the reason that there are no fairs right now, so especially, okay, there was EICMA, but I didn't go there. So at least in Germany there was no fair. So I asked him kindly if he could give me some code, and yeah, he sends me 20% off, and so I bought this tower, and I'm pretty much happy with it. So overall, I can say this bike is for my need and for my suit. And what I use it for, it's perfect. So it's lightweight. It's okay for the road. You can ride it like with 130, 140 kilometers without any issue. The electrics didn't. I had no problems up to now with the electrics. So often you say, okay, yeah, it's better to use some old bike, so you can fix it by yourself. But I have to say, okay, I also don't know how to fix some carburetor and stuff like that. So yeah, for me it's the same. I have to go to the workshop. Small items I can repair by myself. It's not a big issue. But if it gets down to the motor, yeah, unfortunately, I'm not some mechanical engineer, and I try to do my best, but some things I of course can fix. So yeah, up to now it's some good road legal bike. Not road legal because of the fairing, road capable bike, and also some dirt off-road bike with the right tires if you choose them. And I'm quite happy with it, and I hope that you will also got to know or got some impressions of this bike and my build, and yeah, maybe I could help you, and I'm happy to see some more footage from your bike and your build. And yeah, maybe we will meet in summertime when you go down to Austria or wherever you wanted to go from Norway. So yeah, just hit me up. So yes, I just forgot to mention the Krieger OS base rack system. So it's our 6 combo. Yeah, 6 of course for the 6 liters that each pack has. They are completely waterproof. You just roll them down, tighten the buckles on both sides, and you're ready to go. When you fix these leashes here before, on this point that I just mentioned before in the video. So here you have these 2 points on the upside, and of course you have the same ones on the downside, and you just put it through the lug here, and yeah, you tighten it down, and you're ready to go. So you tighten it down like putting this one here to the backside, and it's quite sturdy and fixed. So what I use it for is some tow rope on the outside. Normally I have in this bag some compressor and tire gauge, because on the highway you want to go like with 1.8 bars, and on the off-road I go with 1.4 approximately. And if I go back to my hometown, I want to fill them up, so I have a compressor and a tire gauge in here. And here I normally use a set of tools, with all my necessary tools that I need for this bike, and also with some brake and coupling or clutch lever. And it's like this small bag here. So before I had this one on the fender, but unfortunately because of this big fairing, it's not possible to put it here, or I don't like to put it here in any way. So I just put this one here inside this bag, and I have all my tools and yeah, some small spare items inside here, and I can, yeah. So I'm really happy with this system. This is really small, you don't recognize it while you're riding. For daily trips, it's perfect. And for longer trips, of course, I use a Moscomoto Reckless 80. But I guess you know it, so I don't need to show it. But yeah, overall, these are perfect.